Virgo, welcome to my channel. Welcome to Angel Love 333. We're going to do your weekly reading. This is the week of August 30th through September 1st. As always, may not resonate with every single Virgo out there, so just take the messages that resonate with you. You can check out your other signs, your other placements. I will be doing an extended reading. There's a link below if you want to check it out. It will be for the left portion only of this reading. I do pick up all the energies in this reading, so but just know for the extended, it will be for love only, okay? We will also look at if there's anything showing up for career, finances, and can also be messages, you know, with family and friends as well, okay? So other than that, I'm just going to mention that I do a monthly giveaway. I give away free personal readings each month. To enter, you just need to subscribe, like, and comment, right? If you're already a subscriber, then you just need to like and comment. All right, so we are laying out your cards. All right. Interesting, interesting, Virgo. Okay. All right, I'm definitely getting an energy, Virgo, okay? I definitely feel, I'm not seeing this as finances, okay? I'm definitely picking up a love situation, or I'm picking up a situation with family, a friendship, that type of relationship, okay? I do see here with the Three of Wands, okay? I feel this is an energy where you are exploring your options in a situation. I do feel in the past energy, okay? Actually, I'm just going to say here, not in your past energy, because this is going to be upcoming energy. I feel there's an energy, well, it kind of has to do with the past. I feel somebody may have betrayed you, right? Somebody may have hurt you. It already happened, right? Whatever happened was in the past, okay? Or you just could not be feeling well. That can be that energy as well. But I really feel like it's caused you more to think about the future, think about your options, right? Maybe setting your intentions here. It also can be an energy here of waiting for something, right? But I feel like this is more about you exploring your options, right? And you may already have an inclination of what you're wanting to happen in your situation, because you also have the Queen of Wands here. So if you haven't been feeling good, or someone made you feel down, or somebody betrayed you, I feel this energy with the Queen of Wands, you're going to feel passionate again, right? And I feel like whatever happened in your situation is really causing you to think about the future and what you're really wanting ahead, okay? Instead of waiting for a situation. I don't feel like this is you waiting for a situation. Now, in your past energy, you have the Four of Wands, okay? So this just can be about your happiness, right? Things coming together, maybe more structure in your life. But I'm also getting an energy here, too. This could be somebody that you're dealing with in your family, right? It also can be a relationship. Now, in your current energy, you have the Six of Cups. So I definitely get here that you are thinking about the past, right? Being nostalgic, thinking about past memories. Maybe there's somebody here from your past you're wanting to catch up with, right? You're thinking about. Could be a friend, could be a love relationship, could be a family member, right? As I said, I do sense here that there could have been, this could be a situation with a relationship, and I feel like you're thinking about things. I am going to clarify some of these cards as well, so we'll get more information. Now, I get the energy here with the Eight of Cups. This is in your, you know, this could go either way. This is your hopes and fears position with the Eight of Cups. I feel like some of you are fearing that you may have to completely walk away from a situation, okay? I'm getting that energy as well. But for some of you, I feel like this could be a hope of exploring other options, right? Maybe even a hope of making some sort of change in your life and even a home move, right? Having the opportunity to explore, right? Even travel, I get that energy as well. It's going to be different for all of you. But I feel like this is more of something I feel that could be emotional for some of you, right? Something that you may be fearing walking away completely, or maybe a person has walked away completely in a situation, because I do see in your challenge position is the Queen of Cups, okay? And emotions, right? Okay, so that your emotions may be making this harder for you, but this also can be an energy where you were just very kind and giving to this person, right? Now, in your energy around you, you do have the Six of Swords. Okay, so if you have been exploring the option of making some sort of home move or doing some sort of travel, I feel that is going to happen here with this Six of Swords. For others, I feel this is an energy of you moving on from someone or something. Like I said here with the Eight of Cups, maybe some of you have the fear of completely moving on from a situation. But at the same token, I feel there's an energy here where you're doing something here where you're moving on from a conflict or a particular person. Or you're even making a home move, because this is going to make you feel more at peace, right? There's also an energy here of taking the knowledge with you, right? Some of you may be making a move where you're taking your children with you as well. And this is, like I said, I feel like this is you exploring your options. So there may have been some sort of hurtful event that is getting, things in motion here. Now, in your outcome position, you have the Queen of Swords. This is you being really clear what you want, right? You being very logical, you being very discerned, right? Not letting the emotions get in the way, because I see that as your challenge here, okay? This also can be an energy of clarity or communication. So let's clarify the cards. All right. Thank you, angels. Ooh. All right. As I say, clarity and communication, the moon card drops out, telling me here that you may not be feeling too clear. There can be a lot of emotion there. Okay, clarifying, the Six of Cups is the Two of Cups. Let's get another card, please. And the Chariot. Yeah, and look at that. This is what I'm feeling. The Devil card. You could be dealing with a Capricorn. You also got fire energy here. You got water. Got strong Cancerian. You also got air energy as well. Clarifying the Six of Cups, you have the Two of Cups, and you have the Chariot. Okay, so I do get that this is a particular person that is very dear and close to your heart. And I feel there's an energy of, you want to go travel and you want to go see this person. Maybe you're making that decision here because that Six of Swords energy can be about travel, right? But this also can be about you making a choice or a decision to move forward in your life, right? What makes you happy? A card of success ahead here, okay? And as I said, this can be somebody here that you're wanting to catch up with, right? Maybe you're going to travel to go see this person, and it can be a family member, right? It doesn't mean that you're, for all of you, this is not a situation where you're making some sort of decision to walk away from a particular person. I feel here too, this could be also you traveling, going to see somebody, right? Even possibly thinking about making some sort of home move as well, okay? Or some of you may be in pursuit of traveling right now, because that is in your current energy. I'm going to clarify the challenge. We're not going to clarify the hopes and fears, because those aren't reality, right? They haven't happened yet, okay? So let's clarify your Queen of Cups. You have the Justice card, the Three of Pentacles, and the Eight of Pentacles. Okay. I feel in your situation, you know, for those of you who are feeling a bit emotional about a situation, okay, I feel there's an energy here where you're just wanting fairness and justice in the situation. Three of Pentacles. All right, so you may be wanting to work on things with a particular person, right? Catch up with that particular person. You know, or see some sort of effort from this person. This person's showing you, right, that they still care, that they want to work on things, okay, that they make three things right in the connection. I feel like that is what your emotional side is saying. And whether this is a love, you know, or just a family member or somebody else, I feel like you're feeling like the right thing for this person to do, right, is to, make things right? Bring things into balance. You two of you connect and work on things together, right? Bottom of the deck here, you have the Seven of Cups. So again, a lot of emotion here, mixed emotions, and look here, you have the Six of Swords. So I feel like you may be having confusion, mixed emotions, right? About walking away from a situation, maybe making a home move here, right? Some of you could be involved in some sort of legal situation I'm getting here as well. Or maybe you have some sort of special project or do something for working. You may have to travel. Okay, let's clarify that Six of Swords. Why is the Six of Swords here, please? All right, you have the Temperance card, Sagittarius, you have the Eight of Swords, and the Four of Wands. And bottom of the deck here, you have the Ten of Cups. So it's definitely an energy here. You exploring your options, right, for your future happiness. Trying to get to a place where you can feel peaceful. But at the same token here, you have the Eight of Swords and you have the Temperance card. There's some sort of divine timing or, you know, maybe delay here in your situation that could be, you know, stopping or delaying movement in your situation. Okay? Because I feel like you're trying to make some sort of decision here. Some of you, I feel like, could be a decision about a home move. Some of you may be traveling to see someone. Some of you may, it may be traveling for a special project. Okay, but I definitely get a relationship or family situation here with this Four of Wands. Okay, and you know, the Eight of Swords tells me definitely an energy here where, you know, your fears may be blocking this movement forward. Okay. Right, because in your fear position is walking away completely, right? Or in search of something else, some other opportunity, right? Let's clarify that Queen of Swords. And this has to do with your happiness, obviously, right? What's going to make you the most happy in the situation? Why is the Queen of Swords here, please? Why is the Queen of Swords here? You have the Magician. You have the Sun card, King of Cups. Look at that. Bottom of the deck here, you have the Queen of Pentacles. I feel like for some of you, got a couple things going on here. You know, it may not be one situation because, as I said here with the Three of Wands, you have options or you're exploring options. So this could be encompassing both love, career, and even some sort of move. But I do see with this Queen of Pentacles, it's a very nice energy. Okay, so there could be some sort of offer being presented here to you, but this, I feel like too, it's more of an energy of you making things happen in your life. You choosing what direction you're going in, right? You taking the lead here, moving forward. Though I do feel like some of your fears could be holding you back a bit, right? And I feel it just is more of a stable, independent energy here. This is definitely your energy here, Virgo. And look what's below that, right? Repeating energy, Queen of Swords in your outcome. Okay, so this, I feel like this is about you just doing what's good for you. Some of you just may decide here to really be focused on your career, your money here. Some of you may, like I said, be pursuing some sort of home move, right? Or making an offer, okay? Could be some sort of job offer at a distance I'm getting as well. You know, the Magician, the Sun card, and the King of Cups. So if it comes down to the outcome, I feel it's an energy where things are coming together for you, Virgo, in a nutshell. I do see that. The only thing that I feel it could potentially be holding you back at this time is staying stuck in some sort of mindset, whether it's a particular person, right? Maybe you're just needing to move on from this person. Right, maybe they're toxic, or didn't treat you right, or maybe this person isn't coming forward and they're not wanting to work on things. Either that, or I feel here, you know, this is just about your happiness, you making things happen in your life. Happiness starts with you. I feel this is your emotional happiness, you know, finding that stability. And I do see beautiful things here with the Sun card, okay? But I feel like it's, you know, you being looking at this from a very logical perspective, right? And not letting the, not getting caught up in the emotions or this person did me wrong, right? And they need to fix it type of energy. Because you could be waiting for somebody to do that and they may not ever come around. I'm not saying that this person won't, okay? Some of you could be in a twin flame connection here as well, because you have the Four of Wands twice. So sorry if you can hear my dog. She's barking here. So Virgo, if this is a situation, like a love situation, that you're trying to decide whether you want to move on from the connection or not, I am going to take this to the extended. We're going to look at how this person is thinking and feeling about you, their upcoming actions, love messages, and guidance. I will also take a peek at new love as well for you too, because I do see here you creating your own reality here, your own new beginning, exploring options. So I do feel like new love is a possibility as well. So I hope to see you on the extended, Virgo. I hope you all have a wonderful rest of the day or evening, and I'm sending you angel love.